everyone, and welcome to Daytime. Now, we're going to start off the show with a really great game called Cricket. Please help me welcome Ranil Mendes. He is the director of CIMA Canada. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you, Sonia, for this opportunity.
My pleasure. This is a game that is, you know, on the rise. Everyone in North America is loving cricket. Can you tell me how and why it has just, you know, become such a huge, huge thing?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question. Cricket, unlike any other sports that we see here in Canada, is a global sport. That means the huge influx of immigrants coming from all over the world bring their passion to this great city of Mississauga, Brampton, and the GTA, as a matter of fact. So with that, what you have is a growing demand for cricket.
Absolutely.
And not only the people who are coming, what I see now in schools is that first-generation Canadians, because of the influence from their parents, they are picking up the game. For example, I took a bunch of kids to a session at City Council. They all picked up the game right here in Mississauga and Brampton.
That's amazing.
So that's the beauty.
Is it easy to play?
Very easy to play. As long as you can follow and have a little bit of patience, you'll get it.
Okay, I don't have any patience whatsoever, but you are going to try and teach me how to play the game.
That is correct.
All right, so how do we get started? What do I need to know?
Okay. Basically, the idea is this. There's a, let's start the most simple instance, right? You are throwing a ball.
I'm throwing a ball?
Yes. We call it, I'm using the term just to be familiar with the baseball terminology.
Okay.
But my idea is to defend a target. Your idea is to hit a target.
Like baseball and hockey combined and bocce.
That is correct, in a way you can think of. But it's basically, the one end, you have the bowler throwing the ball to this target.
So I'm over here?
Yes, you are over here.
Okay.
In ideally, in a real setting, it's about 22 yards between the two. They're called the wicket. These two are wickets. So you have 22 yard spread.
So let's just pretend that this is the 22-yard spread.
Correct.
Okay,
yeah.
Now what am I doing?
So you are... Your idea is from there, we'll talk about bowling later.
Okay.
You throw in the ball to hit the target. The target is to hit the ball to any one of the three and bring these bales down.
Oh,
that's
so I'm trying to knock it off.
That's right. So you are targeting your ball to hit this target.
That is like baseball.
This is, well, baseball you have within
a pitch,
yeah,
right.
Yeah. So
okay.
you miss it. But here, the most simple instance would be to explain where I, as a batsman,
now you
would
have
be
a bat.
Standing. Okay. I have a bat.
So you're like the goalie.
That's right.
Look
a hitter,
at all this,
right?
This sports analogy.
So I would be waiting for your ball to come where your objective is to hit the target.
Right.
My objective is to defend the target.
Oh, are we running at all?
We are running.
No,
everything's around.
Happened. Okay.
But everything running, the other ways of getting out, will revolve around the basic idea of a bowler bowling and the batter trying to defend.
So I'm a bowler.
You are a bowler.
Okay. So you were running around, but this is my target.
You are targeting this wicket.
Now, how about if I don't knock down the pins, but I knock down the top part? Does that still count?
You knock down this?
Yes.
That's the idea.
That's still...
If you hit the wickets, but this is called bales.
Bales.
If it does not drop, I am not out.
Okay.
Your idea is to hit the target, which is the wicket, these individual
stumps. Can I just go for the bales?
You could go for the bales.
Just knock down the bales.
Now nobody's defending. Maybe you can go and see how you can target it. Yes.
All right, let's see. And is it an overhand or underhand? Does it matter?
It is overhand. That
overhand.
Would be the next step. Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
You hit the target.
Yay!
You hit the target. You got it right. Now when you get the middle stump, that means you hit the real bullseye.
Yay!
That's that's a really good hit.
How many points is that?
I'll talk about points after. But
okay.
The idea is to hit the target when somebody is defending.
Right.
Now that would be a challenge.
So I didn't really get it.
Okay.
But hey, I'm pretty good at knocking down the middle
one.
Yes,
you were very good. So the idea is that. Yeah.
What if I hit the right or the left?
Does not matter as long as the bales drop.
Okay. But you said that
out.
The middle one was good, was better than the other two.
Well, in a sense, regardless of whoever the defender that faced your ball will have to go back to the pavilion. That means he's out. It doesn't matter where it is hitting here or there, but there's no value to it, there's no points to it. But when you hit the real middle stump, mm-hmm. you achieve something really great. So that's what it is.
Yes. I'm impressed with myself.
So let's talk about points.
And that doesn't happen all the time.
Yes.
Okay.
When you talk about points,
yeah.
So the second stage of this game would be, as a batter, not only do I have to defend my target,
yes.
but I should attempt to hit the ball along the ground or above the bound lines
okay.
to get points. So the batter earns points while defending the target.
Okay.
Bowler try to contain the points and
by trying to
attack.
Get that.
Yes.
So I'm containing the points, you're trying to get the points.
You are trying to hit the target, I am trying to defend the target.
And so I'm trying to get you out, essentially.
That is correct. Well, yes,
okay,
that
from
is correct.
Grabbing points. All
right.
So now what do you want to do next?
So
you want to try?
After that, what will happen is the next stage
yeah.
of the game, if I were to explain, would be instead of me alone at the batter, there will be another partner of my team.
You have a partner?
Yes, a batting partner
okay.
on the other hand. You, on the other hand, you have a team of 10 other players on your side. Let's say this is the CIBC trophy that we are
yeah.
going to have May 14, 15.
Yes.
You are Mississauga
You're
High
Brampton.
School. I am a Brampton High School.
Okay.
I am North Park, let's say.
Yeah.
You are Father Gates in
yeah.
Mississauga.
Okay.
We are the champions of these two, Mississauga versus
yes.
Brampton. Father Gates High School
yeah.
is bowling at North Park team.
Mm-hmm.
My batter will have only one partner waiting
You've
at that end. I'll tell you that.
Okay.
But Father Gates, you have 10 other Father Gates cricketers.
Do they have balls in their hands?
No, only
no,
one ball.
Just me.
So the original explanation still is valid. You try to hit my target, I try to defend and get points. You and your team will have to contain the points.
So what is my team doing?
Yeah, yeah. That's a good question. So your team will have, so let's say I not only defended, but I hit the ball that way
okay.
and I am now getting to get points. Your 10 other players of the Father Gates team will run and catch the ball and try to stop that running.
Okay, so let me try this again. And I want you to try and defend this time.
That's right.
Okay, go for it. Let me see. And then I want to try to defend while you try to get a point. Ready?
Yes.
Oh, is that where you stand?
Yeah, yeah. This is the way
Can
the batter
I move
will
over?
Stand. Yes. Now 22 feet is what we. Well, that's
all right. I'll stand
22
here. How's
yards,
that?
Yes.
Okay. But you're like right in the middle of my target.
That's the idea.
Oh, that's the idea.
The idea
are you cheating?
Is
okay.
If I defend my target
yeah.
using my body, which means legs,
mm-hmm.
we call it leg before wicket. And you can appeal to the umpire,
yeah.
but the real way to defend is defend from your back.
Right, not your body. Got it. Okay,
yes,
ready?
Yes.
Watch your face.
Yes.
Because I don't have that great
aim. No problem.
Okay, ready? Whoa!
That's all right. Ideally, the ball okay. is a leather ball.
Can you grab that for me?
I will be wearing a helmet. Now,
okay.
that is a rubber ball.
So that didn't hurt you?
No, not at all.
Oh,
not
right.
at all.
Okay.
That is a rubber soft sponge ball. I brought it
okay.
for that purpose.
Thank you. All
so
right.
that so I don't need to wear all
the event
equipment.
Is taking place on May 14th.
14th to 17th.
17th. Wonderful.
And it is the CIBC trophy.
Yes.
CIMA Canada, which is the organizers, are spreading this tournament to
yes.
Markham,
perfect.
Mississauga.
Thank you so much, Daniel.
It was
a pleasure. Come on back because we have kittens and we're going to learn how to train them. It's kitten kindergarten right after this quick break, so come on back.